Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 11.3. Number one, we're asked to solve a triangle if we're given A is 5, beta is 60 degrees, and C is 10. So the only convention we're sticking to in the book is that alpha A, beta B, and gamma C are angle side opposite pairs. Right, so when I go to sketch this generic triangle here, I'll call that angle alpha, that beta, and that gamma. The length of the side opposite alpha we're going to call A. The length of the side opposite beta we'll call B. The length of the side opposite gamma we'll call C. All right, so we're told that A is 5. C is 10. We don't know what B is. We don't know alpha. We don't know gamma. But we're told that beta is 60 degrees. Now, we can't use law of sines on this, which is what we learned in 11.2, because to use law of sines, I need to get an angle side opposite pair. And there's no way at this point I can do that. So, law of cosines. To use law of cosines, I need two sides and the included angle. All right, from geometry, this is the side angle side case. And we're guaranteed there's only one triangle that satisfies these conditions. So since I have two sides and an included angle, I can go after side B. And once again, it's a modification of the Pythagorean theorem. B squared equals the sum of the squares of the other two sides minus 2 times the product of those sides times the cosine of the angle between them. So b squared in this case equals a squared plus c squared minus 2 times a times c times the cosine of 60 degrees. So I get 25 plus 100, that's 125 minus, remember the cosine of 60 degrees is 1/2, so I've got minus 50, and this gives me 75. So solving b squared equals 75 gives me b plus or minus 75, but since b is supposed to represent the length of the side of a triangle, I'm going to take the positive square root, and so this simplifies. This is 3 times 25, that's 5 radical 3. All right, okay, now it's time to go after the angles alpha or gamma. At this point, we could use the law of sines, even though we're in technically the ambiguous case angle side side. There is only one angle defined, and we could use law of sines to do that. If you're going to do the law of sines route, I recommend always going after the largest side of the triangle first. But I'll use law of cosines all the time because there's no ambiguity there. So for law of cosines, let's say I want to go after gamma, then I can use cosine gamma is equal to the sum of the squares of the adjacent side. So that'd be a squared plus b squared minus the square of the side opposite gamma over 2 times the product of the adjacent sides. So in this case, I got 5 squared plus 5 radical 3 squared minus 10 squared over 2 times 5 times 5 radical 3. So I get cosine gamma is what? 5 squared is 25. This squared is 75. That's 25 plus 75. That's 100 minus 100. That's 0 over 50 radical 3, which is 0. That means that gamma's got to be our good friend 90 degrees. So this, in fact, is a right triangle. Gamma is 90 degrees. I can quickly then find alpha. It's 180 minus beta minus gamma. And so that's just going to be 30 degrees. So in fact, what we have here is a right triangle. That's a 30, 60, 90 right triangle. All right, for number two, we're asked to find the area of the triangle in number one. Now, if we're just not given any directions on that, we can go back and use the formula we learned in geometry. Area is 1/2 base times height. And since this is a nice, friendly right triangle, the base is 5 units long, the height is 5 radical 3 units long, so I get 25 radical 3 over 2 units squared. That's the area of that triangle. So, why are we asking to go by Heron's formula? Well, we want to practice Heron's formula. If you're in a non-right triangle and you know all three sides, Heron's formula is a way to get to the area. So let's review Heron's formula here. The chief principle here in Heron's formula is the semiperimeter S. So S is the semiperimeter. And so it's you take the perimeter and divide it by 2. So in this case, we'd have 1/2 5 plus 5 radical 3 plus 10. And so this gives us 15 plus 5 radical 3 over 2. And according to Heron's formula, the area you get by taking S times S minus the length of each side, and then taking the square root. And this is a consequence, once again, of the law of cosines. So let's go through and find each of these pieces. Let's take S minus A. So that would be 15 plus 5 radical 3 over 2 minus 5. 5 is 10 halves, so that would give me 15 minus 10, or 5, plus 5 radical 3 over 2. S minus B would be 15 plus 5 radical 3 over 2 minus 5 radical 3. This would give me 10 radical 3 over 2, so that would be 15 minus 5 radical 3 over 2. And then S minus C would be 15 plus 5 radical 3 over 2 minus 10. That's 20 over 2, so that would give me a negative 5 plus 5 radical 3 over 2. So I multiply these together along with S, and then take the square root, and I should get back to that. All right, then I would feed all this in the Heron's formula. Okay, so Heron's formula says I got to take the product of S, S minus A, S minus B, and S minus C. Then I would take the square root of all that. Okay, so let's just work with this, and we'll take the square root here at the end. Let's see what we've got going on. In the denominator, that multiplies out to 16. From each of these factors in the numerator, I can take out a 5. So I have 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. That's 625. If I take a 5 out of the first quantity, I'm going to be left with a 3 plus radical 3. From the second quantity, a 1 plus radical 3. A 3 minus radical 3. And a negative 1 plus radical 3. 625 over 16. You've got the difference of squares going on here. It'd be 9 minus 3, so that gives you a 6 from that from those two things. And you've got the difference of squares actually happening here as well. You can think of this as radical 3 plus 1 times radical 3 minus 1. That gives you 3 minus 1, which is 2. So really what you've got going on here is 625 times 12 over 16, which I can reduce to 625 times 3 over 4. So according to Heron's formula, the area then is the square root of this whole thing. which is the square root of 625 times 3 over 4. The 625 comes out as a 25. The 4 comes out as a 2. But I'm stuck with square root 3. And once again, it's an area, it's a unit squared. And that checks with what we got using the basic formula for geometry. All right, so we're forcing Heron's formula here to get practice with it. And we're seeing that it really does give you the same answer as you would getting the area any other method. That'll do it for checkpoint quiz 11.3.